Measurement of angles, level 9. In this final video on measurement of angles, we will go over two final examples that require the use of algebra to solve. Let's take a look at the first example. If angle POA is a right angle, and if the measurement of angle POC is 3 times as large as the measurement of angle COA, find the measure of angle POC. In this problem, we are provided with a figure, along with geometric and algebraic relations of two angles. We are asked to find the measure of a particular angle. We know from the problem that the measurement of angle POC is 3 times as large as the measurement of angle COA. So if we use the variable x to represent the measure of angle COA, then the measure of angle POC can be expressed as 3x. From the diagram, we know that the measure of angle POC plus the measure of angle COA is equal to the measure of angle POA. Using this geometric relation, we can go ahead and substitute the algebraic and numeric expression for the measurement of the angles. We also know that angle POA is a right angle, so we can replace the measure of this angle with 90 degrees. Now it is just a matter of solving for x. Doing that, we obtain x equals 22.5. We can now use this value to determine the measurement of angle POC. Substituting this value into the algebraic expression and simplifying, we obtain 67.5 degrees for the measurement of angle POC. And this is our final answer. Alright, let's move along to the next example. Given that angle TRS is a straight angle, angle TRX is a right angle, the measure of angle TRS is 2x plus 5y, and the measure of angle XRS is 3x plus 3y. Solve for x and y. In this problem, we are provided with a figure, along with two algebraic expressions, one for each angle. We are asked to determine the values of x and y. Notice that in this problem, we actually want to solve for x and y, just like we did in our introductory algebra class. The only difference is that we need to use the geometric relations to set up an equation and solve for the variables. Let's first label the diagram with the given information. We know that angle TRS is a straight angle. It measures 2x plus 5y. We also know that angle TRX is a right angle. So we go ahead and draw a square corner for this angle. Since angle TRS is a straight angle, the sum of the measure of angle TRX and XRS must equal 180 degrees. Since the measure of angle TRX is 90 degrees, we can conclude that the measure of angle XRS is also 90 degrees. Hence, both angles are congruent, meaning that both have the same measurement. So the measurement of angle XRS is 90 degrees. Now we can equate the algebraic expression for the measurement of angle XRS with 90 degrees. Notice that we now have two equations and two unknowns. At this point, the problem becomes a system of equations problem, similar to the ones covered in a typical beginning algebra course. Again, if you're a bit rusty on this topic, I recommend you go back and review this topic. We're going to use the elimination method. In this case, we will eliminate the variable x. So we need to multiply the first equation by 3, and multiply the second equation by negative 2. Doing that, we obtain the following. Next, we go ahead and add the equations. Now that we have an equation with a single variable, we go ahead and solve for y. Simplifying the expression, we obtain 40. The last step is to substitute this value into one of the original equations and solve for the variable x. Let's substitute this value into the second equation. Solving for x and simplifying, we obtain negative 10 for the value of x. So x equals negative 10 and y equals 40. So this is our final answer. Alright, and we are now officially done with the measurement of angles video series. In our next series of videos, we will go over the concept of collinearity.